Welcome back. It's stable for the market, so let's concentrate on the personal finance segment. Harshvardhan Roongta of Roongta Securities joins in. Well, the topic for today is generally we're talking about insurance today, as we always suggest that financial planning is not actually complete without insurance, such as life cover, Mediclaim, etc. However, when it does come to finally making a claim, many people actually face a problem of their claims being rejected. So what are the options with policyholders in such cases? We'll dwell into a couple of these options.
Well, go ahead, Harsh. That really is the question to you. What is the procedure to file a claim, and what should an insurance holder keep in mind when he files claims?
Well, Lata, we have seen a lot of cases, even in the consumer courts, which are like pending because insurance claims have been rejected. When the consumer has filed his claim and everything being in order, but citing some reason in the policy document, the insurance companies have rejected the claims. Now this leads to a consumer feeling absolutely cheated, and he feels harassed that he has to go through the expensive and often time consuming process of the consumer court. Now, in order to instill that confidence back into policyholders, the Government of India has inducted an office of the insurance ombudsman. Now this is a platform in which if there is any grievance related to your claims, you can appeal, file a complaint in this office, which is absolutely without any cost to the consumer, and he can seek a review, he can seek an award and decision based on the rejection. Now this office is extremely cost effective. There is no, as I mentioned, there is no cost whatsoever to the policyholder to file his complaint with the ombudsman. He doesn't need to even hire a lawyer. He doesn't need to go through an agent. He needs to himself be present there. Usually the award is given with within one or two hearings itself. Mm-hmm. So it is far more speedy than what we look at from the consumer point of view.
But is it easy
now,
for
there are a couple of other parts.
Yeah, Harsh, is it easy for a individual to argue his claim before the ombudsman, or would a lawyer be advised? After all, the individual may not know the nuances like precedents or the fine print. So should the claimant go and argue his case on his own, or should he better look for an expert? As well, in the banking ombudsman case, what we find is that they're seriously backed up. Is this ombudsman so completely backed up that he will be able to give you redressal in time?
Absolutely. In fact, as a matter of rules for filing a complaint is that you cannot hire a lawyer.
Oh.
You cannot be having an insurance agent or an industry expert assisting you with them. Why? Because the ombudsman's office is fully equipped. In fact, they have their own staff over there who look at the case in a very neutral manner, and they argue the case on your behalf. So it's an extremely consumer friendly process, wherein a consumer should not think twice, should not hesitate before filing his complaint with the ombudsman, and he will surely get. See, insurance ombudsman is basically hired either from the insurance industry himself, or he's from judicial services or the civil services. So the person is adequately capable of looking at the case in a neutral manner. It's a consumer friendly process, as I've kept mentioning. So they're trying to keep it extremely simple, away from involving lawyers, and keeping it cost effective for the consumer. So that's the process. And insurance, the award, it's interesting to know, the award given by the insurance ombudsman is binding on the insurance company. So insurance company cannot further go and appeal against the order of the insurance ombudsman. However, the choice is given to the individual. If he is not satisfied with the award, he can further go to the courts. So it's a completely consumer friendly process, as I've again mentioned to you.
Harsh, just stay on. It's time for a break, and we'll get talking about some queries with regards to this topic once we're back. Stay tuned.
Before we went into the break, we were speaking with Harshvardhan Roongta about the problems that you can face when you file claims against your insurance policies. And he was speaking to us about the insurance ombudsman, an office that's extremely consumer friendly. Okay, now, Harsh, we have some people with exactly those kinds of problems. Joining us now is Tarun Kumar Garg. He calls in from Bombay. Go ahead, Tarun. What is your question?
हेलो मैम, मेरा क्वेश्चन ये है कि मुझे मलेरिया था, जिसके वजह से मैं हॉस्पिटल में एडमिट हो गया था. हॉस्पिटल से बाहर निकल बाद मेरी माता जी गुजर गए, तो उसके काम में वो मैं बिजी हो गया. अब मैंने क्लेम उसके बाद मेरा फाइल किया तो 38 डेज हो गए। अब मेरा क्लेम इंश्योरेंस कंपनी ने रिजेक्ट कर दिया, बोला है कि 30 दिनों में ही क्लेम फाइल करना है। क्या कर सकता हूँ मैडम?
ओके हर्षवर्धन, यू कैन रिप्लाई इन हिंदी बट दिस लुक्स लाइक अ डिफिकल्ट केस।
नहीं तरुण, एक्चुअली मैं आपसे कहूँगा कि इंश्योरेंस जो आपका डॉक्यूमेंट है उसमें वर्डिंग्स वेरी क्लियरली है कि आपको जो क्लेम है हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन के 30 दिन के अंदर आपको फाइल करना है, और TPA ने जो आपका क्लेम प्रोसेस किया है दे विल गो स्ट्रिक्टली बाय व्हाट द टर्म्स इन द पॉलिसी आर। लेकिन फिर भी मैं आपसे कह रहा हूँ कि आप अपनी इंश्योरेंस कंपनी के जो ग्रीवियंस सेल है, पहला रिड्रेसल जो मैकेनिज्म है कि आपका क्लेम रिजेक्ट हुआ है, उसी इंश्योरेंस कंपनी के ग्रीवियंस सेल में आप एप्लीकेशन दीजिए। उसमें बताइए कि आपने आपका डिले किया किस कारण से हुआ था, कि उसकी वजह आपके आपकी फैमिली में डेथ हो गई थी उसकी वजह से आपने क्लेम फाइल नहीं कर सके, विच इज़ वेरी नॉर्मल। दूसरी बात है कि अगर आपके ग्रीवियंस सेल भी आपको एक्सेप्ट नहीं करता है ये आपका जो जेन्युइन रीजन है और आपको वो क्लेम फिर भी पेएबल नहीं करता है, तो आप इंश्योरेंस कंपनसेशन में 100% अप्लाई करिए एंड आई एम वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट कि आपको आपका क्लेम डेफिनेटली मिलेगा। दूसरी बात आपके लिए बहुत ज़रूरी है कि IRDA ने सितंबर 2011 एक साल पहले करीबन उन्होंने गाइडलाइंस सारी इंश्योरेंस कंपनी को दिए था वाइड उनके एक सर्कुलर इशू किया था कि अगर कोई क्लेम जेन्युइनली पेएबल है उसे कोई भी इंश्योरेंस कंपनी रिजेक्ट नहीं कर सकती सिर्फ एक कारण से कि उन्होंने टाइम पे सबमिट नहीं किया। सो आई एम वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट कि ग्रीवियंस सेल में ही आपका जो क्लेम है वो एडमिट हो जाएगा और आपको क्लेम मिल जाएगा। प्लीज परस्यू इट फॉर श्योर।
Oh, that's most helpful, Harsh. This is something which I guess all of us would benefit by. These deadlines can sometimes steal you or rob you of very genuine claims. Go ahead.
Absolutely. Well, do remember that you can join us at any time, or rather the same time tomorrow as well. Uday Dhoot will be joining in tomorrow to tell you everything you ever wanted to know about the debt mutual fund. Thanks, Harsh Vardhan, for joining in.